This is Heinz Hornung speaking, CEO of Felicitas Customized Engineering. I will now demonstrate how to install Felicitas PCBSIm and have for this a brand new virtual machine. The installation is done in the following steps. We will first have to select the modules we want to install. We will install PCBSIm. In this instance, we might install Eagle if it is not already installed on this computer. Then the installation is done for the interface between Eagle and PCBSIm, and we will make a short step afterwards. All this is fully automated, so it's not at all complicated. So I'm starting the installation process. It's asking whether I trust Felicitas, which I do. Then it's showing the license agreement, which I accept. And we are now already at the step select the modules. Here, the most important part is the Eagle installation. If you already have the Eagle installation, then you don't need to select it. I don't have it on this computer, so I will install it as well. So I press the next button. It asks me for the destination folder. For PCBSIm, I accept the default. It asks me for the start menu folder, and I also accept the default. And now it's unpacking files. I will hold the video for a moment here because this is not too interesting. It now has unpacked the files, and it's now installing the copy protection device. This might take up to 30 seconds, so I'm holding or I'm pausing the video for a moment again. The copy protection device has now been successfully installed. I accept this. So now we are already at the installation of Eagle. So I'm pressing the setup button. It's unzipping the files, which is again not too interesting. So I pause again. The Eagle setup has been unzipped. It's now showing the welcome screen, which I just accept. Then it's showing the license agreement. I continue as well. It asks me for the destination folder for the installation of Eagle. Normally, I would not change this. If you do, you need to change this later on in the PCBSIm installation as well, or in the interface installation. I leave it as default. So it's summing this all up. And now copying the files. Again, not too interesting, so I'm pausing here again. So the installation of Eagle has been finished. It now asks me what license I want to use. For this demo, I'm using the freeware license. Of course, for commercial use, you would have to buy an appropriate license. So the setup of Eagle is completed. Now the interface installation continues, the interface between Eagle and PCBSIm. And it asks me for that, for the destination folder of the Eagle installation. I have not changed it before, so I leave the default here as well. It has copied an Eagle SCR file to an Eagle back file, .back file, because the Eagle SCR file needs to be modified for the interface between PCBSIm and Eagle. So if you have made modifications to it, you will find it again in the Eagle.back file. And that's it. PCBSIm is already installed now, and if I close this, it will show me the tutorial in the browser. This help is always accessible with PCBSIm. Just press the F1 button at any dialog. For the time being, I will close this now, and I will start Eagle. Here we go. Eagle is now asking whether it should create the users directory. Yes. And I'm starting PCBSIm. So we have now started Eagle on one hand side, and PCBSIm is coming up on the other side. PCBSIm is at first scanning the libraries for a search index, and then it's displaying the demo restrictions, which I just accept. Then I will nicely Oops. Sort them. So now with Eagle, we have installed a number of examples under Projects Examples Felicitas, and I'm opening one of these, for example, AC Sweep. And what we see is in this familiar Eagle program, we see two more buttons which allows us to simulate the design. So the installation has been successfully finished, therefore we complete this video for now. Thanks for watching and bye for now.